Good morning or good day. Welcome, like every day, to Real-Time Daily Trading Ideas. We have 5 days a week, 5 different traders. We will speak about trading ideas, strategies, market screening, maybe 1 or 2 questions from your side directly answered on our webinar. Our goal is quick and smart, but for that daily, so let's have a nice start. Also today on Tuesday, on Wednesday, it's Wednesday, 6th of June 2018. We will start, like every day, with our risk disclaimer. Forex and CFDs are leveraged products and can result in losses that exceed your deposits. If you are a starter, please start with a demo account and make yourself familiar with long trading, short trading, leverage trading, and your personal risk management. If you'd like to read the full risk disclaimer, just visit one of our web pages, for example, admiralmarkets.com, and you will find everything written down or displayed there. This is our scheme. On Monday, it's Jay's day. On Tuesday, it's Paul's day. Like today, on Wednesday, it's Giancarlo's day. On Thursday, it's Marco's day. And on Friday, it's Dirk's day, our leading day traders live every business day, every trading day to the same time. This is me. My name is Jens. I'm the German guy from Admiral Markets. I'm talking from the Berlin office. We are a big international broker with over 18 country offices. So my English made in Germany, but hopefully my quality too. But I'm not the main speaker. The main speaker is the day trader of today. This is Giancarlo. And now I can say welcome to Giancarlo. It's your time. What's your view to the markets today?
Good morning, trader. Good morning, gents. It's a pleasure to stay here with us today. Sorry for 1 minute late because I have some small internet problem, but now it's all okay. Well, as we know, we have a particular situation in Italy and Spain, and the market is focused now, especially European markets, focused or these political events. We know that in Italy we have a new government, the Conte government, and now this Mr. Conte has to demonstrate that it will carry out the necessary reform to revive the country economy as soon as possible. In the same time, in Spain, in Iberia country, the leader of the socialist, Pedro Sánchez, after having replaced Mariano Rajoy as the new president of the government, he has to present the program and list of ministers. So this week we have a small few macro data, but very important political event. Outside of Europe, the reflectors always focus on the trade war between USA and China. So the investor are waiting to understand what is the possible reaction of United States after the decision to introduce new tariff by Trump administration. Today, it's not so. We don't have a lot of important macro data, but it's right to we have to focus on two very important news: the balance of trade in USA and the Canadian region, and of course the AAI crude oil stocks change. So we start today with oil, because we have to, just a moment, we have to, would like to focus on the on this very important instrument, because we have assisted in last week a very important sell-off, and we have to understand what's happened in oil markets today. We know that the price are under pressure due to concern over rising USA production and fear of an increase of OPEC output. So we have assisted this movement for short seller and profit takers cover position. So after the strong breakout of $70, we have assisted a great down trend that stopped exactly where we have suggest to view last week, in $64.22. Exactly here is a very important support of smart money. We have assist a stop of this downtrend. Well, what we have to we can do here, it's very important to understand that the traders waiting for 22 of June of the one of the most important meeting of year of OPEC, and in this we can assist a very volatility movement and aggressive trades by institutional investors. So the first thing that we understand that nobody likes to sell on weakness. So every pullback we can assist could be a very important occasion for bearish traders. So don't be very excited for this rally. My suggest today is to take a look. First one, it is very important smart money zone. I always remember that the green rectangle represented the pressure of smart money in our analysis, and you know that we have great resistance here at 66.60, and we maintain our support here in 64.22. We can start a short trade if.
Now I lost your voice. Can you still hear me, Giancarlo? Some problems with your local provider.
You hear me? Hello? Hello?
Now you are back. We had a delay or a break of 10 seconds,
okay.
But now you are back.
Okay. I have all an order here. Do you hear me, gents? Hello?
Yes,
hello?
You are back.
Hello?
Yes.
People say the sound is good. Ah, okay. May I continue? Audio and video, okay?
Yes,
perfect.
Please.
Okay, thank
life
you.
Is life.
So I would like to remember that today, if price maintain below 65.26, we can start to view short with first target to go near this very important support. In case we have a strong breakout, we have to start to find this very important target between 63.25 and in extension 62.51. For a long position, I suggest, at least for the most aggressive trader, to take a look if price go inside this rectangle. So on up 60.60, we can try to go to some long with first target here at 60.62. But I suggest some swing trading only if price go up this very important or the zone of $68. So we're speaking about oil. We now take a look at dollar, Canadian dollar, because we are assisting a very bullish pressure. They would like to comment some important level for this week. And first one, I would like to remember that if price maintain this very important support 1.29, and in special is shown in 1.2850, we can maintain the long we want the bullish view. So from today, I suggest to take a look if we can break out this zone of last webinar 1.3038, because in case of very stronger breakout of this zone, we can start a new uptrend with the target here in 1.3177. We can use the pullbacks for short for buy opportunities, and I would like to remember that with the higher interest rate in the States and failing oil market, it has a bit of sense that this pair could continue to go forward and higher. So in long term, our objective is 1.35, but take a look at this zone, because in case we have strong breakout, we can have a very good buy opportunity at least of 150-200 pips. I would like to remember in any event that the next week we will have the FOMC meeting, and we have on Friday another very important event, that is the deadline of future equity and option. So we can assist the high volatility next week. In this case, now it's logical that we take a look at Standard & Poor's, because as you remember, I always suggest in past week take a look at this resistance. In 2,642, we have assisted this breakout this week, and now we have to put our idea in the bullish direction. The condition today to have a good buy opportunity is a strong breakout of this level, so we can have a buy opportunity with of 10 points until this level, and we can stop for today buy idea if the price going below this zone of 742, and especially we lost this very important support, intermediate support in 744. The trend remain bullish, and until we maintain the price up this level in 700 and logical this in 684, the smart money resist and maintain a bullish pressure. We can we so we can say that reasonably that the risk on price action continued in the market. I would like to show or what's happened this day in the Nasdaq, because due to political or economic problem, Nasdaq composite the breakout our zone here in 7023, being supported by the strong demand of for FANG stocks. FANG, it means Facebook, Amazon, Netflix, and Google. And we investors are strong believe that this equity remain immune from any fallout from a trade war. So now we are a very interesting situation, because we have touched our resistance here in 7,185, and now if we maintain this zone and the price at least remain up of 7,100, we can start a new uptrend with first target here in with in 341. It's logical to think a very ambitious target, because we know that in Nasdaq index is we have a lot of money from Fed and from investor in research on development. We can change idea only below this level, and until we maintain this zone, of course, you have a great buy opportunity every pullback. So now we are going to take a look at our my favorite index. We start with DAX. DAX is very high volatility this day. Now we are going to take new hike just to take a look in daily charts what's happened. We have assist a normal correction after this very long uptrend movement from end of March, and now we can assist at least a new after this pullback a new uptrend due to the movie the Italy and Spanish problem. For now, until we maintain the zone between 12,533 and 6,811, we can maintain a long view in medium term. In four chart, we have prepared our the smart money pressure. We now have a great pressure of from yesterday here in 925, and only a breakout of 800 we can give us a reasonable possibility of short. So today, as we start, I would like to give you a long entry here, but price is very fast. So today I can suggest first one that due to the volatility we have to wait a lot for position. You can last in the last position was very good. Our long here up 444, we can take more of 50 pips, but today it could be a little difficult because the market remain in a range situation. So first one, we have here this support. This is intermediate support. Second one, Until we maintain the price up of 80, 120, we maintain a long view. I suggest to try a long here because the price could arrive now here without problem. If someone can would want to open some buy position, you can try here. Here we have a very important resistance. So my idea is to buy today if we have a strong breakout of the last resistance here. We have the target here in 971, and stop of 30 pips is more. So, more it's very sufficient. For short, I suggest at least if price going down this soon, 821, stop here. And the first target could be here in 798 in the station here in 770. In any event, I suggest to maintain a lot of care because we have a strong movement and after very low volatility, so we can enter in some trap of smart money. And in general, for this week, remember that if the price maintain this zone between 756 and 770, we maintain a long view. But in the same time, if we don't break out this zone where we can put our entry, we have to maintain a lot of attention in for a strong pullback. I would like to finish just take a look at dollar yen because we know that the bullish trend of index markets is well viewed here in dollar yen. Dollar yen respect this zone in 80 108. So now we have to maintain attention. If the price break out this zone, we can have a new hike between 111, and our target remain this in 112.67. Only a strong breakout of this zone, especially the last minimum, we can have a strong sell-off. But sorry, strong correction. A good sell-off can start if we break out this zone of 170.51. And just to take a look rapidly, gold, because we maintain the zone on 1,300, is a very strong weekly resistance. I suggest to have a long view if we break out this zone, but in case we lose here 1,286, we can start a new short. Finish with the Bitcoin because we maintain this very important zone of 7,369, and if we have a strong breakout of this region, we can take $6,000. Only up 9,145, we can start to create some long position. Thank you very much for your attention. If there are, I am at your disposal for any question. Thank you.
Thank you, Giancarlo. Tomorrow is another day. Tomorrow is day trader Markus. So if you like to see and view also different trading styles, just try to join us more days, like only not only today. We are available every day to the same time. That's Realtime Daily Trading Ideas. Thank you, Baader Markets. Greetings from Berlin office. Bye bye.